Love, 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 la 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 la. Welcome once again, guys, to the Steve O'Ken Guitar Channel, and this is a fabulous Sunday morning, and I'm going to make a tutorial of the song Medicine by Ben Soul that was released almost 4 or 3 days ago. This is going to be an amazing piece of tutorial. Stay tuned to the end. Great, so the song, as you can agree with me, is a sweet one. And this tutorial, I don't want it to be too long. And I have made it in a very simple way, such that even a beginner will be able to play it. But here, the challenge comes that the song, by the way, is in the key of A flat, or as some may call it, the key of G sharp. Now, this key may be challenging for beginners, especially for those who have only learned about the open chords. Because as you can see, I'm playing with the capo at the first fret. In this way, I am able to use the shapes of open chords. And we will see which shapes I'm talking about. The other alternative is by playing bar chords. But this is for the advanced people. If you are a beginner, this will be challenging. But if you are a bit more advanced, you can use the open chords. And for the open chords, remember, this is the C chord. Now we go to the, this is the G chord. Now the next will be the G sharp or the A flat. So now this is how you play it in the bar chord. But as I said, this tutorial, I'm going to make it so that everybody can play it irrespective of your guitar skills. So I'm going to use the capo. Of course, if you don't have the capo, you can still play the open chords, the G, and as we shall see. But of course, it will not sound in the same key as the original song, but still you can train in that as you wish. So because I want to be in the same key as the song, I'm going just to place the capo at the first fret. Okay, my capo is in place. As usual now, the good thing about the song is that it uses the same chord progression from the start to finish. And it's a very simple chord progression, as we are going to see in a few minutes. And of course, it has the sweet chorus that repeats itself, love, 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 and then we have a number of stanzas. But once you master the chord progression, it applies for the entire song. Now, what chords do you need to play the song? As I said, I have made this in a very simple way. As a beginner, the usual chords that you learn on the guitar, the three easy chords as they have come to call them, G chord, then we have the C chord, and the D chord. And with those three chords, G, C, and D, you will be able to play the entire song. For those of you who may have challenges on how to play the chords, I will just brush up very quickly. But if you want to know how to play the chords G, C, and D, watch my video on the only three chords you need as a beginner. I'll send a link at the end of this video. So very quickly, before we move on to the chord progression, for you to play the G chord. Now at this point, I think I'll zoom in a bit so that you'll be able to see. Great, guys, so I've zoomed in a bit. I think now you can be able to see the six strings easily. So this is how to play the G chord. For those of you who are absolute beginners, you need these three fingers, the little finger, the ring finger, the middle finger. So the middle finger goes to the second fret, fourth string. The ring finger goes to the third fret, sixth string. The middle finger goes to the second fret, fifth string. Then the ring finger goes to the third fret, sixth string. And then the pinky or the little finger goes to the third fret, the first string. You make this shape. Then quickly to the C chord, you need these three fingers, the ring finger, the middle finger, and the index finger. So the ring finger goes to the third fret, fifth string. Then the middle finger goes to the second fret, fourth string. And then the index finger goes to the second fret, second string. And remember, in this case, I'm counting the frets from the capo. If, of course, you are not using the capo, you will count them from the nut here. So when I say the second fret, I'm referring from the position of the capo. So this is the first fret, second fret, that way. Then we go to the last chord, which is the D chord. These are the three fingers, again, which you need: the ring finger, the middle finger, and the index finger. So the index finger goes to the second fret, third string. The middle finger goes to the second fret again, first string, and then the ring finger goes to the third fret, second string, and you make this shape. And of course, for the D chord, you strum the lower five chords or the lower five strings or the lower four strings. For the C chord, you strum the lower five strings, and then for the G chord, you strum all the six strings. That's just a quick reminder. So we move on to the chord progression for the song. What is the chord progression for the song? So for the chord progression, it's very simple. Of course, it's the three usual chords, 1, 4, and 5. But this time round, we move from 1, then we go to 5, then we go to 4, then we go to 1 again. So it's 1, 1, 1, 5, 5, 4. So 1, 1, 1. 5, 5, 4, 4, 4, 1, 1, 1, 1, 5, 5, 4, 4. So the chord progression is 1, 5, 4, 1. Or for those of you who know them in terms of the names, we have the G chord, then you move to the D chord, then you move to the C chord, and then you move back to the G chord. So G, D, then C. Great, I think we have gotten the concept of the chord progression. So we move to the next part, which is the strumming pattern. Now the strumming pattern, again, I've made it in a very simple way. The strumming pattern is down, down, then up, up, down, up. So we have down, down, up, up, down, up, then you move to the next chord, down, down, up, up, down, up, then to the next chord again, down, down, up, up, down, up, then to the next chord, down, down, up, up, down, up. Now at this point, I will encourage you to listen to the song as many times as possible so that you internalize it. Then that way it will be easy for you to play it on guitar. And also it will help you to understand where to make the chord changes. So, how does the strumming sound like? So as you have noted, I'm staying on the G chord. At the beginning, I'm staying on the G chord for two measures. In other words, I am repeating the strumming pattern twice for the G chord, but for the D chord, it's once, and for the C chord, once. So I want you to look keenly and listen. So that is the second time. So the first time, one, 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 two, one. So that's very important for you to note, for you to be able to play the song. Great. So we are almost done. So we now know the strumming pattern is down, 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 up, up, down, up. So So that's how the song plays. Now I'm going to play the song on my radio and accompany it with the guitar so that you feel how it sounds like. So guys, you have heard me playing the guitar while accompanying the song as it's playing in the original key. Now, having done all that, I think I've come to the end of my video. And as usual, remember to hit the subscription button for this channel and the notification bell so that you don't miss any amazing videos from this amazing channel. And as usual, let me know your thoughts by leaving your comments in the comment section below. Until then, see you in the next video.